بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اليوم إن شاء الله نتكلم عن نيوكلاسيزم وهي الحركة الكلاسيكية الجديدة، وحنتعرف على تعريفها ومزاياها وأهم كتابها. Definition: Neoclassicism comprises a return to the classical models, literary styles, and values of ancient antique Greek and Roman authors. We know that literature began with the Greek, then followed by the Roman. Neoclassicism refers to a broad tendency in literature and art enduring from the early 17th century until around the mid of the 18th century, 1750. Neoclassicism means return to the rules of the classical works written by Aristotle and Homer, Virgil, and all Greek and Roman writers. They were the pioneers of literature. They were the beginners of literature. عندما نتكلم عن الكلاسيكية الجديدة نتكلم عن العودة إلى الماضي، إلى الكتابات التي كتبها هومر والتي كتبها أرسطو والتي كتبها أفلاطون والتي كتبها فيرجل، القوانين الكلاسيكية التي تحكم ضوابط اللغة وضوابط الأدب وعدم الحياد عنها. هذا كان جوهر الحركة الكلاسيكية الجديدة واللي تسمى نيو كلاسيزم. نيو كلاسيزم الكلاسيكية الجديدة والتي اشتهرت في أوائل القرن السابع عشر حتى منتصف القرن الثامن عشر. Neoclassicism is dated from 1660, and when I say 1660, it marks the beginning of the Restoration era and the return of Charles II from France, ruling England, and the end of the Republic, led by the late Oliver Cromwell, and the return of the monarchy, and it is the beginning of the Restoration era, beginning of a new Neoclassicism from 1660 up to 1780. We will devote a lecture about the Restoration later. It is called the Augustan period, attributed to the Roman Emperor Augustus, whose rule was a golden rule at that time. It is a conservative movement, Haraka Muhafiza, believed that humans were fallen, وكان عندهم اعتقاد بأن الإنسان خطأ وليس معصوم من الخطأ. Observed a disparity between the past and the present, they made a comparison between the past and the present, exalted the past, boasted of the past, celebrated the past, احتفلوا بالماضي وبالإنجازات الأدبية التي كتبت أثناء اليونانيين والرومان. Saw the present as a debased ورأوا أن الحاضر هو حاضر وضيع محتقر use satire and irony واستخدموا طبعا السخرية والهجاء لانتقاد الواقع الاجتماعي. So the history of Neoclassicism dated from 1660 up to 1780. It is called the Augustan period. It is a political name attributed to the Roman Emperor Augustus, whose rule was a golden rule during the Roman Empire. It is a conservative movement, believed that humans were fallen and humans can make mistakes, observed and watched a disparity between the past and the present, exalted the past, saw the present as a debased, used satire and irony. Then we have the Neoclassical period, 1660 up to 1798. More details about that period. They used to emphasize on reason, logic, order, balance, individual over group. تركيز على العقل وعلى المنطق وعلى النظام وعلى التوازن وعلى الفرد على حساب المجموعة. John Locke said social contract exists between the government and the people. العقد الاجتماعي يوجد بين الحكومة والناس والشعب. Means that the relationship which binds the government and the people is a social contract. Natural laws of life and the life of each individual must be respected, and he has natural rights like liberty and property. When I say liberty, that the human being is free. And when I say property, he has the right to own. Logical justification for glorious revolution. And we know well that while the logical justification for the glorious revolution, which was in 1688. This, as I said, is the era of restoration. Restoration followed the era of Oliver Cromwell, the era of the Civil War, where Protestants defeated the Catholics, and Oliver Cromwell killed Charles I. We will talk about that in detail when we talk about the religious reformation, Islah al-Dini, in England, and when we talk in detail about the 17th century and what happened there. Believe that man is basically innately evil. وهؤلاء كانوا يعتقدون أن الإنسان بالفطرة هو شرير. That man is basically and innately evil. إن الإنسان بالفطرة هو شرير. Improved masses impoverished masses begin to grow. والناس الفقراء زاد عددهم because of decline of farming, demise of a traditional village life. Decline of farming because the English society is moving from rural society to industrial one. And the land where farmers used to work and feed their families are sold to industrialists in order to build on them factories. So it was the sudden demise and the end of the countryside, the English countryside, and the decline of farming. Farming, which was the only means for families to feed themselves, is replaced by industry. And that led to thousands of people who become very poor. And when I say impoverished masses, I mean poor masses. الشعب أصبح فقير لأن النظام البريطاني تحول من نظام زراعي إلى نظام صناعي فصفوا الآلاف من الناس بدون مصدر رزق وهذا أدى إلى انهيار الريف والحياة الريفية البسيطة وأدى إلى انهيار نظام الزراعة وبلشوا الناس يذهبوا إلى المدينة ويبحثوا عن لقمة العيش وهذا ممكن تعرفوا بالتفصيل في محاضرة The Victorian Age العصر الفكتوري موجود على القلم. Poor living, working condition, terrible working condition resulted. Disagreement about reform efforts ومشاحنات حول جهود الإصلاح. Also, you will find in detail about the change of the British society from rural to industrial throughout the Victorian age, and you can watch it on the channel on the lecture about the Victorian age and the changes which happened during that time. So impoverished masses begin to grow, decline of farming, demise of a traditional village life, موت الريف البريطاني. Poor living and working conditions, women and children and men, all they were working in very terrible conditions. Working and living conditions, overcrowdedness, pollution, diseases, disagreement, demonstration, calls for reform, calls for high pay, calls for equality. It was the beginning that society starts to call for changes, changes which can improve the lives of the British people. So disagreement about reform efforts. All that happened during the Neoclassical period from 1660 up to 1798. Means middle of the 17th century up to the end of the 18th century. Age of Enlightenment, عصر التنوير. Also the Neoclassical period is called the Age of Enlightenment. Neoclassicism refers to the Western movements in literature, theater, music, and architecture that draw inspiration from the classical Greek and Roman culture. As said, that they were terribly and tremendously affected by the classical literary works and the classical Greek and Roman culture. They imitate what was written by Aristotle, Plato, and Virgil. During the 18th century, a new movement, حركة جديدة, swept through Europe and created a drastic change in politics, science, and art. The Age of Enlightenment was a partially reaction to the Industrial Revolution. عصر التنوير كان جزئيا هو رد فعل عنيف ضد الثورة الصناعية. As the world witnessed the importance of technological innovation for the advancement of the humankind. العالم كان يشاهد أهمية الاختراعات التكنولوجية من أجل تقدم البشرية. The world witnessed the importance of technological innovation for the advancement of the humankind. So the Age of Enlightenment was partially reaction to Industrial Revolution and the change in the British society from rural to industrial and the resulting problems which led to the poverty of millions of British people and the demise of the countryside as said. This Age of Reason, هذا عصر العقل, عصر الآلة, and enlightened thinking, والتفكير التنويري, dominated Europe, يعني سيطر على أوروبا, inevitably piercing two important eras in philosophy and visual art, وفي النهاية أدى إلى ميلاد حركتين وفترتين مهمات جدا في الفلسفة وطبعا في الفن التصويري, visual art. Characteristics of Neoclassicism. مزايا العصر الكلاسيكي والحركة الكلاسيكية. Poetry should be guided by reason. Poetry should be guided and ruled by reason, the mind. So you have to think before writing poetry. Different from the romantic. Romantic, you have to feel before writing poetry. Here you have to think before writing poetry. Second, the role of the poet is that of a teacher. The role of the poet is that of the teacher. While for the romantic, the role of the poet is an inspirer. يعني هنا معلم هنا كملهم. Poetry should be written according to fixed rules. Poetry should be written according to fixed rules means that the poet has to think of the rules rather than imagination, rather than feeling, rather than inspiration, rather than intuition before writing poetry. So he has to think of the rules and the arrangement of the words and the rhymes and the figures of the speech, simile, metaphor, and whatever before writing poetry. Because for the Neoclassicist, the form is more important. The form and the outer form is more important than the content. And that is a major difference between the Neoclassicist and classic poets and the romantic poets. The romantic, they focus on emotion, they focus on the inner feelings of the poet, and the inner feelings and emotions of the poet rather than the outer or the form of poetry. Poetry should use special diction. They here they focus on the language, but while romantic they use simple language because they want to reach all parts and all kinds of the British people, as said, the educated and the uneducated, the educated and the ordinary man, simple man, the educated and the farmer, المعلم والمزارع, people who don't know the decoration of the language, people who can know simple language. But for the Neoclassic poets, people must be very well educated in order to understand their poetry. Why? Because poets focus on the language and the decoration of language. And for that reason, you will find that figures of speech are highly used in their poetry. وإن شاء الله أنا أخصص محاضرة كاملة عن الصور البلاغية واللي حتكون بعنوان figures of speech. So poetry should use a special diction, أسلوب خاص لكتابة الشعر وكتابة الأعمال الأدبية. The major representative of this school are John Dryden and Alexander Pope. The major representatives of this school are John Dryden and Alexander Pope. Characteristics of Neoclassicism. There are four tenets of neoclassical criticism. First, to imitate. The neoclassical critics have a desire to imitate the classical age and the classical writers. يعني كان بالنسبة لهم عندهم رغبة لتقليد الكتاب الكلاسيكيين والعصر الكلاسيكي اليوناني والروماني. To assess. The new classical critics attempt to assess why the classical writers were so successful. طبعا كانوا بيحاولوا انهم يقيموا ليش الكتاب اللي كلاسيكيين القدامى كانوا ناجحين جدا. To revive the neoclassical critics attempt to revive the glories of the ancient classical literature, and they start reviving which the rules and whatever was written during the classical period. Revive the glories, إعادة إحياء أمجادهم, أمجاد الكتاب الكلاسيكيين الذين كتبوا في أيام الإمبراطورية الرومانية واليونانية. To systematize the neoclassical critic attempt to systematize the rules for writing a good poetry. They wanted to put rules similar to the rules put by the classical writers. And for all poets should follow these rules without deviation. كانوا يعني يعيدوا كتابة القوانين ويعيدوا إحياء القوانين الكلاسيكية وعلى كل الشعراء أن يلتزموا بهذه القوانين بدون أي زيادة أو نقصان أو تحريف أو البعد عنها. بنعرف أنه حركات شعرية كثيرة جاءت ومن هناك أضاف ومن هناك اخترع شيء جديد ومن هناك التزم بالقوانين ومن هناك لم يلتزم بالقوانين اليونانية. وأكثر ناس لم يلتزم بهذه القوانين كان ويليام شكسبير والذي اخترع وأضاف وزاد من أجل أن يخلق شيء يتناسب مع أبجديات اللغة الإنجليزية. So when I say characteristics of neoclassicism, there are four tenets of neoclassical criticism: to imitate, يقلد, the desire to imitate the classical age and the classical writers, to assess, يعني to evaluate, أقيم. The neoclassical critics attempt to assess why the classical writers were so successful. ليش كانوا ناجحين؟ إيش اللي هم اللي عملوه؟ فخلينا إحنا نتبع نفس الخطوات اللي أدت بهم إلى الوصول إلى الميت. لليوم بعد آلاف السنين أديبال ذا كينج هي طبعا المسرحية اللي رائدة في كل العالم. لليوم الناس بتتكلم عن الإلياده والأوديسي, لليوم الناس بتتكلم عن الأنين, لليوم بتتكلم عن الأعمال اليونانية والرومانية وإلى آخره. ليش هدول كانوا ناجحين؟ إيش اللي عملوا؟ خلينا إحنا نكتشف الأسباب ونقلدها. هذا كان جوهر الحركة الكلاسيكية الجديدة. Revive the glories of the ancient classical literature. خلينا نحيي أمجادهم ونقلدهم ونعمل أشياء مشابهة عظيمة للي هم عملوها. And to systematize, to create certain rules for all poets and writers to follow in order to write a good poetry. يلينا نخلق مجموعة من القوانين مشابهة للقوانين الكلاسيكية القديمة وعلى الشعراء الالتزام بها. هنا لما أقول systematize وهي كلمة كانت مشهورة الآن في أوروبا ومشهورة في جميع طبعا الدول الأوروبية بأنه